Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Linda. Hope you guys are doing great. Guys, I would like you to hear from the journalists that know everything about Buhari's death. See you in my next video. Bye.
Welcome to this program. I want you to talk, just talk openly to Nigerians.
Hello, good evening and good morning, depending on where you are watching the show from. I want to basically say first, because I understood how Nigeria think and how Nigeria work. They will come up to say, I have been paid. Please, I want to make it very clear. Hope you are hearing me. I want to make it very clear that I have never been paid and nobody paid me for this. The reason why I decided to come out is because of the life that was lost in Nigeria and so many things that is going on at the same time in Nigeria. Hello, can you hear me?
Everybody's hearing you. Go ahead.
All right, thank you. Thank you. First of all, I started doing this on Twitter, but Twitter, they are restricting me. I want to first of all say, you can follow me on Twitter with the name Boris Moro, B-O-R-I-S-M-O-R-O-M-O-R-O. Hello? So the whole scenario is that President Muhammadu Buhari, he died on the 19th of February. On the 19th of February, please, those analysts, if you can take notes, take pen and your paper and note these things down. Note them down carefully. I'll be giving a specific things here, specific details right now. Okay, number one, President Muhammadu Buhari died on the 19th of February, the year 2017. He died in Newcastle, in Freeman Hospital, Newcastle. He died as a result of heart problem, heart disease, which the Nigeria presidency failed to disclose. On the 19th of February, I was in London by the special grace of God. I'm a journalist. I work with one of the Nigeria broadcasting station and one of the leading Nigeria broadcasting stations. So I covered the event in London. He died in Freeman Hospital, Newcastle. I was there. I covered the event. Then, you know, Muslim, they don't embalm people. So on the 20th, February, he was flew in to Saudi Arabia where he was buried. I was there live and I covered the event where Aisha Buhari put on white attire. I think you are with me.
Go ahead.
So where Aisha Buhari put on white attire and
Can you pause a bit? And let me remind Nigerians and the entire world that this event he said he covered. He have the video.
I do.
Go ahead.
I have all the video. So the Nigeria Aisha was putting on white as a sign of mourning to her husband, who is the late President Muhammadu Buhari. Then the children, according to the Muslim tradition, were putting on black. I have the video, I have the photograph and everything. You understand? Then on the 23rd, of February, I was in Ethiopia. As a journalist, I moved around. So I was in Ethiopia where the Africa Union, the AU, hold a summit, a mini silence for late President Muhammadu Buhari on the 23rd of February, the year 2017.
Hold on, please. I know that interrupting you is very, I know this kind of thing is very, very difficult. But please, hold on. Now, you, after covering the event, you went to Ethiopia on the 23rd of April, of, on the 23rd of February. February yes. 2017. And
yes.
you covered, you were there at the African Union Summit or whatever.
Yes.
You covered it with your own camera as a journalist. And yes. you have the video.
Exactly, I
Go
do.
Ahead. Go ahead.
So, I covered the events there where the African Union hold a minute silent for late President Muhammadu Buhari. So, to show their last respect to the late President Muhammadu Buhari of the Nigeria government. Then, on the 28th, on the 28th of February, see, which I think is the last day of February, then, what was it called? Queen Elizabeth gave a condolence statement to the Nigeria government in respect of late President Muhammadu Buhari, and which went viral.
Yes.
So all of these, the Nigeria government led by late Abakari and with the Kaba swept under the carpet for selfish and greed reasons. Then on the second of March, Eric Joyce, the ex-British lawmaker, he issued a statement, that a condolence statement to Nigeria for the loss of her president. Are you with me, sir?
Yes.
Then they swept it under carpet, and the man got angry to, and came out to say that President Muhammadu Buhari is dead. If President Muhammadu Buhari is, if they think he is lying, that they should come out to challenge him. You understand what I'm saying now?
Yes, yes,
that they
yes.
They should come out to challenge him in the court of law, that he will come out with every evidence to prove that Muhammadu Buhari is dead. As I talk to you, since 2017, this meaning, nobody from the Nigeria government all across the nations of the earth came up to challenge Eric Joyce, the ex-British lawmaker. That went by. Then, on April 17th, one American journalist by name Mark Smith, he came up to say that the corruption going on in Nigeria is unbearable, that he can only imagine how the Nigerians are surviving in that country, that there is corruption everywhere. You understand? So we just talked over all this. But what actually prompted me to come up to this tonight is, one, the Nigerian youth have been suffering 60 years of independence, 60 years of suffering and smiling, and yet the government is taking them for granted. Now the Nigerian youth, they came up to say, no, enough is enough. We don't need this anymore. Let's put an end to this. All what they could do was to send the military, it will fire them. If they think maybe I am lying, let Aisha Buhari, the wife of the late President Buhari, come up to tell me that the imposter parading himself as the Buhari is her husband. If I am lying,
okay, hold it there. First of all, I want you to tell me, because you are one of the best journalists, but people don't know. Like I said, you don't need to mention your name. You don't also need to mention the Nigeria TV station where you work and all that. So now, during the time when this man died, I want you to tell me, what did you do? Like, did you contact anybody in Nigeria, like any prominent politicians, and who is the person, and what did you discuss? And can you tell us why, what happened that the Nigerian media didn't carry out the news, including.
Unfortunately, that Abakare is dead. Abakare did not die of COVID-19. Coronavirus did not kill him. They masterminded his death. That is number one. I have proof for everything I'm saying, because I am a media personnel, and for me to say whatever thing, I know I can prove it anywhere on the earth. You understand what I'm saying? First and foremost, after that, we came to Nigeria and we tried to publish the news. Let me state categorically, I don't want to mention the name of broadcasting this thing I work with. Our firm was suspended by the National Broadcasting Commission, NCC, NBC, National Broadcasting Commission, suspended our firm, our broadcasting station from airing because we carry the news.
Because they know, they have information that you were there. You were there, yeah, and you followed everything. So when you came to Nigeria, they suspended your firm.
So I'm coming to that, sir. Let's not rush it. Abakare called me to Aso Rock. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
So I flew into Abuja to go and see him, and he told me that if I can keep quiet, that my safety to be alive will be guaranteed, and for my generation to come, no, we suffer again as a result of the bribe he was offering me. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
So I told him, accepting bribe is not the problem, but my conscience will judge me till I die.
Yes.
So I cannot do that. And to God who made me, I'm saying this categorically, and God Almighty is my witness, I did not take a dime from him. So I left. Then I called Bola Tinubu Asiwaju, the Lagos State richest man on earth. Let me use the word. So I called him. I called him on his MTN line. I can call the line now, the MTN line that I use in reaching him. I'll say it here. The number is 080-622-40104. That is the number I use in calling Bola Tinubu Asiwaju. So I called him on phone to tell him about the development. And he came on to tell me that I should shut up, I should keep quiet, and so many other trash and nonsense that he told me, that at the end of the day, I was suspended from my work. You understand? As a journalist.
Okay, hold on. Hold it there. So you called Bola Ahmed Tinubu to tell Tinubu, of course, you normally call him too. This is not the first time you are calling him, by the way.
We normally communicate.
Okay, so you called him on this number you called now, 080-622-40104.
Yes.
And then he tell you to shut up and tell you a lot of things.
He specifically, I can still remember, I still have the record of that conversation. You understand? Because as a journalist, you keep record of things, because years to come you might need it. You understand me?
Okay.
So I still have the record of that conversation. So when I called him, he told me that Nigeria is not like other country. That Nigeria hems of affair revolve and must continue to revolve around the cycle. You understand now?
Mm-hmm.
He told me that it must continue to revolve around the cycle, that the system of governance in Nigeria is different from every system of governance in the world, on earth, that in Nigeria, transparency is is something that they don't toy with, that they try to hide everything, that it's not everything the masses must know. It's not everything the masses, the people of Nigeria must be aware of. Are you getting what I'm saying, sir?
Yes.
So he told me, and he offered me money too. He offered me a bribe. He said, as long as I kept quiet, then I called the vice president too, Yemi Osinbajo.
You called the vice president too? Okay.
Yes, I have his contact, but I for security reasons, I wouldn't want to disclose his contact to the public. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, go
but
ahead.
Go ahead. So I called Professor Yemi Osinbajo. I called him. I went to his office to meet him in Asorok in Abuja. So when I got there and I told him, sir, we understood because I was the one that covered the news. I'm from Soso Place. I introduced myself to him and he welcomed me. He sat me down. I told him this according to the law that I know because my father is a Nigerian. You understand me now? My father is a Nigerian. My mother is from the British. He's from England. So I told him that according to the laws that are known in Nigeria, when the president died, the vice president automatically will become the president. You understand? As a way of moving the country forward. He said that the Nigerian government is not run in that system. I said, no, when Goodluck Jonathan was there, that was what happened when the president died. He was the vice president and he came up to be the president. You understand what I'm saying? And he said, please, for my safety, I should keep quiet and go my way. That the course of things will play out by itself in Nigeria. The reason I got to understand that
Can you pause a little bit, please? I know that this is very difficult, you know, when I'm, you know, pausing you all the time. So is it that because of the way you have actively trying to air this news was the reason why you were suspended and sacked or something?
I wasn't sacked, sir. Suspended.
Okay, you were suspended. Okay. So was it the reason? Was it the reason you were suspended?
Yes.
Okay. All right.
I told them that I will publish it. Then as at that time I was receiving so many threats, like seriously, people started threatening my life, threatening me so here and there. Then I called Erufai, because Erufai was there when Buhari was being buried in Saudi Arabia. Erufai was there, the Sultan of Sokoto was there, Ganduje was there. As at that time, then about 10 or 11 persons, prominent people from Nigeria were there, including other people who came to the burial ground. But the people that were there, Erufai was there. The Sultan of Sokoto was there. You understand what I'm saying now?
Yes.
So when they were burying him in Saudi Arabia, and they started threatening me. At that time, they threatened me. Because I told them I would publish the video. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
And I understand that many of them are hearing me right now. I understand that many of them will come up to say it's a lie, nothing like that happened. But if any of them can come up to challenge me that this and this and this I'm saying now never happened, I will be very glad because I will pick it up from there. I will take it to the court, to the International Court of Law. Let Aisha Buhari come up to tell me that the man he's posting as a Buhari is the real Buhari. I will come up with every evidence, including the video of how he was wrapped with the Nigeria flag,
yes,
with the green, white, green cloth. Okay. I will come up with the video of everything.
Okay,
Let them come and challenge me.
Okay, hold it there. So actually, the video and all these pictures were taken away from you, but you have your own backup as a journalist.
I always have backup.
All right.
always have backup. My camera was seized as a journalist. It was seized at the airport in Lagos.
Your camera was seized at the airport as you are coming back to Nigeria?
Yes, in Lagos.
Okay.
Till today that I'm talking to you, I've never set my eyes on that camera.
But you have backup.
You understand
what I mean? They didn't know that. You know, they are
of course. Of course, I have all my backup. Even this evening, I was going through the backup. I was playing all of them. I was going through them again. So if they want to debunk this thing, I'm saying that it's a lie. Nothing like that happened. How come the AU, the Africa, our presidents, heard a minute silent for them? As at that time, I could remember I called the president of Ghana on this issue. The president of Ghana told me that it is not in their interest that if the people of Nigeria cried out for 30 days, that is when they will take up the case, that the AU will take up the case. As long as nobody has cried out, that it is assumed that they understood what is going on, that in Nigeria is not Ghana. That is what the president of Ghana told me. You understand what I'm saying now? Yeah. I understand that many of them are hearing me right now. Let any one of them come up to challenge me. I went to Ethiopia. I spoke with a prime minister, with one of the lawmakers there, and he told me that it is not in their interest. Then I accused him of being bribed. If not, he would have come up with an action, because he is the secretary of the AU, of the African Union. You understand me
as
now?
As at then.
Yes, as at that time. So I challenged him. I accused him that they have been offered bribe, and he told me that he has never received any bribe from Nigeria, though many of them are coming with proposal. But whether he later accepted bribe, I don't know. You understand what I'm saying now? But the truth is this: Buhari is long dead in Freeman Hospital in Newcastle in London on the 19th of February, the year 2017. He is dead. Buhari is dead. He was buried in Saudi Arabia. Nobody can tell me that he's still alive. Buhari, that I know, if you look, you know, when the Kano came up, you understand, they said that he's talking rubbish. I have never met Nnamdi Kanu on face to face. He doesn't even know me. He doesn't even know whether I'm fair or black. He doesn't know me. And I've never given him anything. He has never given me anything. You understand that? But the truth is, as a journalist, I swore an oath to stand by the truth at all times. Irrespective of what may be at stake, I swore an oath to God and humanity.
And now you no longer work with this television station. And now, because of what is going on in Nigeria, you are ready to shatter the table.
If I am not answerable to any Nigerian authority, you understand now? When I was suspended, I was waiting if my suspension would be lifted. I waited for a period of 6 months. My suspension was not lifted. Then I resigned. I sent them my resignation letter. Then I left. I started my own firm by myself. You understand me now? Which I am growing by the special grace of God. You understand what I'm saying now?
Then what we do, because a lot of people, of course, a lot of people are demanding that we are not going to discuss here, you know, whether we are going to, how we're going to bring video to start flashing and stuff like that, because we want to be killing them, slowly. So we want to be killing them slowly. It is not going to be boom. So a lot of people are saying we should bring the video. We are not going to respond to that at this point, whether we are going to bring the video or not. But so long as they are following the program, following what we're doing, the videos and evidences will be dropping bit by bit.
All right. Thank you, sir. Please, I want to say something, sir.
Okay, go ahead.
Thank you very much. I appreciate you. I appreciate what you are doing, and I appreciate the good people of Nigeria who stood up to say, no, we cannot face this anymore. I appreciate all of you. But one thing we must understand is the unit the spirit of unity has to be strong in the Nigeria youth. You understand what I'm saying? Because any protest that does not last for 30 days cannot draw the attention of the European Union and the African Union. You understand now? Yes. So if I'm saying this to the Nigeria youth so that they will understand what they are doing. You understand? Because right now, revolution is what is needed. That is what the Nigeria government are doing everything to block everywhere. Mm. That is why they paid people to go and shoot. Those are the people, those are the military that Buhari ordered the shooting. And the governor of Lagos State, Sanwo-Olu, said that there was, at first, I watched him, he said there was nothing like that. Then I called him on the phone. That was day before yesterday.
You called someone on the phone day before yesterday.
I have their number. I called him on the phone and I asked him, why are you saying this? It is obvious across the nations of the earth. Why are you saying this? People will come after you. The Nigerian youths that I know there are calm, but when you toy with their simplicity, they will come after you. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
Then I believe that was later when he came up to say that they thought nobody died, but he began to look for possible means to change his mouth. Mm-hmm. Then I called Bola Asiwaju. Then when I learned that he was in France, I flew into France to go and see him, but I was not allowed to see him in his France mansion. You understand? Then I called him on his phone. His phone was switched off and he couldn't attend to my call. Then I went to his LinkedIn page. Yeah, I went to his LinkedIn page to contact him. And when I contacted him, he told me that he was never the one that ordered the shooting, though he was aware of it. I was asking him, why did you order people to remove that camera? He said he was not the one, that it was the governor, Sanwo-Olu, that ordered them to remove it, that nobody can remove it except the governor signed it. Mm. So the governor of Lagos State, he was aware of what will happen. He was aware that soldiers were going there. He let any of them come up to say this is not true, and I will publish the voice S notes, the voice recording through LinkedIn that I communicated with Asiwaju, Bola Tinubu. You understand what I'm saying tonight?
Yes. Thank you very much. You know, some people will be saying, oh, this thing is not adding up. You know, sometimes when you are in the field, the way this Nigeria politicians, the way this Nigeria story goes, you know, sometimes it will go up and go down. Some people may not be, you know, getting the point. Some people may not understand, you know, why would you go to France? Why would you do this? You know, but when a journalist who is like, you know, dealing with all these politicians in Nigeria, and you want to be the person to have the first-hand information of whatever that is happening, and especially when you are out of the game, especially from the Nigeria space, and now you want to be, you know, you want to have first-hand information of what is going on. You know, sometimes when something like this happens, of course, you can fly to anywhere just to get the information and get the first-hand information, you know, to have it in your own space. But anyway,
sure.
I must thank you very much. This is the first time you are talking to anybody about this.
Yes.
This is the first time ever you are talking to anybody about this. We are going to continue our discussion. It is not going to be online. It is not going to be live. I will now allow you to go, and we continue from here. Thank you very much for being part of this program. I really appreciate you.
Thank you so much.
All right. Thank you.